So the next topic is the relationship between the drift velocity and current density J. First, you know what is drift velocity, and now what is current density? First, we must know what is current density. Current density can be defined as the current, the amount of current flowing per unit cross sectional area of the conductor is what we call the current. I'm connecting a battery to this conductor, right? I'm applying electric field of strength capital E. I'm applying electric field of strength capital E. Here I'm taking one cross sectional area. This is what we call the cross sectional area 1. Here I'm taking another cross sectional area 2. The distance I'm taking as L. So, as it is a conductor, the moment I apply the electric field, what happens? The electrons will attain some velocity, and at that velocity, they will start moving in all the volume. So I know that there are n number of electrons per unit volume, but So this particular volume I want to calculate. So I know that L is the number of electrons per unit volume, or we can say the free electron density. Right. So for this much of volume, how many number of electrons are there? So that is what I need to calculate first. So the charge present, in this particular, in this particular volume can be taken as dQ. So the charge present in this particular volume is taken as dQ. So volume into the charge of each electron. Okay, the number of electrons in the given volume charge is equal to number of electrons in the given volume into charge of each. The first thing, in order to calculate the charge present in this volume, what I need to calculate is, first I need to calculate number of electrons which are present in this volume, which should be multiplied with the charge of each charge carrier. Okay? So this is a total charge which is present in this volume. In order to calculate that dQ, the first thing what I need to do is I need to calculate number of charge carriers with the number of charge carriers which are present in this volume into charge of each charge carrier. Okay, so now first I'm going to calculate the number of electrons in the given volume, and we know that per unit volume, L is the number of electrons. And what would be the number of electrons present in this volume? So this volume can be calculated.
So DQ may be taken with an X.
Cross-sectional area 1 and reaching the cross-sectional area 2 in time, dt seconds.